Time South today, we're featuring one of America's hottest new acts, Cheap Trick, which are taking the world by storm at the moment. Excuse me.
Hey, that's Tracy, Rog.
Right.
On Good Time Sounds today, we're featuring... Oh, sorry, you guys, wrong page.
Cut.
All right.
Three.
On Good Time Sounds today, we... Oh. Hang on. Sorry. On Good Time Sounds today, we're featuring one of America's hottest new rock acts, Cheap Trick, who are currently taking the world by storm. They're going to be visiting New Zealand next week, and...
Take 20!
On Good Time Sounds today, we're featuring one of America's top rock acts of the decade, Cheap Trick, who are currently taking the world by storm. They'll be touring New Zealand next week, so we thought we'd go about and ask a few Aucklanders their opinions on Cheap Trick. Excuse me, what do you think of Cheap Trick?
Oh, Cheap Trick? Is that a racehorse or something? No, never heard of them, sorry.
Excuse me, could you tell me your opinions on Cheap Trick?
Yeah, they're all right. Yeah, they're pretty good.
They're all right? Would you like some stickers of Cheap Trick?
Yeah, I wouldn't mind.
All right, I've got some neat badges here. Seeing you're a fan, who do you like best out of the whole group?
Oh, the lead guitarist.
Do you know his name?
Oh, Rick Nielsen, yeah.
Rick Nielsen, good one. Pleased to hear it. Thank you very much. Excuse me, could you please tell me your opinions on Cheap Trick?
I've never heard of them, sorry.
Oh. Excuse me, sir. Could you tell me your opinions on Cheap Trick?
Cheap Trick? Oh, a lot of fun, Cheap Trick.
By
the way, what about a badge?
Oh, would you like a badge?
I'd love a badge.
We've got one here for you, actually.
Great.
Would you like it on your tie?
It'll go straight on there.
Good one. Thank you very much, sir. Well, there's just a few opinions of Aucklanders around town on this brilliant new band. But let's get on to the special. Let's get this on the road. We've got a couple of songs here from a 1978 tour in the US of A. There's Hello Kitties and Ready to Rock. Cheap Trick.
Thank you.
They may be crazy, but they certainly aren't lazy, because Cheap Trick are one of the hardest working bands on the rock circuit today, and they've built up a huge following in Japan, Europe, and the US of A. With 5 albums released, each one doubling the sales of the preceding one, these 4 talented rockers seem to be set for superstardom in the 1980s. Their 4 very distinct personalities combine successfully in their live concerts and contribute to their wide appeal. The crazy man on lead guitar is Rick Nielsen, who co-founded the band back in 1972 with drummer Bunny Carlos while they were in France. Rick has always loved British rock, and one of his major influences was The Who's Peter Townsend, whose onstage antics resemble Rick's. He is by no means a copier, though, and his songwriting talents and sense of humour are an important part of the band. Drummer Bunny Carlos is a straight man of the group, and his powerful drumming style has been described by critics as one of the best in rock. Bunny is never without his white shirt, tie and glasses, plus his cigarette. Lead singer Robin Zander, the blonde heartthrob of the group, is the one who pops up in teen magazines and posters. He works really hard on stage, and Cheap Trick have been playing an incredible 300 performances a year. The 4th member of the band is Tom Peterson, who gives Cheap Trick their driving bass sound. Tom loves silk shirts, and with Robin, makes a perfect contrast to the 2 unusual figures of Rick and Bunny. In Japan, their stage show won them a lot of fans.
In the U.S. for the cheeseburgers.
That's true.
I'm aware of that fact.
What do you think about that?
Sounds good.
Yeah, with all the sheep here, you know. I hear there's 72 million sheep.
And
3 million people, or the other way around, I'm not sure.
No, I think you got it wrong.
All right.
What does that mean?
That means there's lots of sheep, you know. Means there's a lot of wool clothes. Yeah, I got a wool sweater here.
Sheep Trick, you know.
Yeah.
Like you say in France.
That's right. That's what they say in France, you're right.
The expression Cheap Trick doesn't really have the same meaning here as it does in the States.
Well, it has no meaning in the States either.
Yeah?
No, not really.
I don't know.
Well, what does it mean here anyway?
In the States, it's a joke to make you laugh without you knowing it or something. It's a
good catch, huh?
Since we saw a lot of bands putting on makeup and jumping around and using $10 million laser lights and things like that, and we thought, we can do better than that, and we don't have to spend $10 million, and we're a good band, a good musical band, we like what we do, so we have fun on stage, we like to rock and roll, we like our audience to rock and roll. It should do pretty good in Auckland. three gigs.
Yeah,
he's sold out and stuff. That's good. That's good. Had you heard anything about some audiences and stuff here?
Well, I hear the audiences here are crazy, and I think that's great. I heard there's a definite correlation between people that are like this and people that like music, you know, so it always worked for me. I've been nuts all my life, so I can understand that.
Do you want to stop or just carry on? How's Karen doing?
I'll have to read my
sometimes. Take one.
This is Kiwi Carlos here. We're talking to Rick Nielsen from Cheap Trick.
Hey, how you doing, Kiwi?
Rick, you just flew in yesterday. How's New Zealand look? How's Auckland?
Well, the weather's been fine so far. We had a little rain yesterday, but today the weather is fine. I think we're anticipating quite an event over at the Town Hall in Auckland for the next three nights.
I know you're premiering the Dream Police set in New Zealand and Australia. How do you think the kids are going to go for it?
Well, I don't know. I hope they like it, Bunny. You know, I hear the people in New Zealand are probably equally as crazy as the people in the United States. So I think being that we released the Dream Police album first in New Zealand and Australia, and that was the premiere of the world premiere of our new album, I would say that the people here have already had maybe a touch too much, you know, a little bit out there, I would guess.
For the guitar fans.
Iced tea here. I enjoy this stuff.
For the guitar fans, we know you own at least 100 guitars. How many did you bring to New Zealand with you? Did you bring a lot of guitars?
Well, Kiwi, I only brought, I believe, 40 with me. And I was trying to cut back on the airfare. The price of hauling the equipment over here is very expensive. But we brought about 40 vintage things, like some old Gibson Flying Vs and some Gibson Les Pauls for all you guitar fanatics. And for the people that don't know anything about guitars, all it is just a lot of guitars. It's, you don't need to know about any of the models, Kiwi.
Sounds good. Between you and Bunny, the oddball members of the group, and Tom and Robin, the handsome debonair flash members, it looks like it's going to be a good gig.
Yeah, I would say so, Kiwi. Should be a great show. Hope to see you there at the Auckland Town Hall for the next three nights. Sounds like a good one.
Right, here we go.
I'm not the best interviewer. You
wrong way.
Dom, no, I'll take it from the other
way. Right. Good.
Yes, sir.
Tell me about your sort of stage act, your sort of madness on stage.
Well, I've had trouble when I was in school. I'm still having trouble learning how to play guitar. So one of the things I do is I just play lots of guitars, and that way I don't seem to have much trouble anymore. And I do take my vitamins every day, and they do taste wonderful. Although I had a few taken away at customs at the airport yesterday. Yes, go on, Kiwi.
That'll do. He's Kiwi, not me. Okay. Bunny, tell me, what's behind the deadpan expression with the cigarette and behind the drum kit? Well, what are you thinking about?
When I was a younger man, I used to drum for Chuck Berry and Bo Diddley and people like that, the rock and roll guys I'd get on the tours, and they didn't like you making faces. They didn't like you doing drum rolls. They didn't like you stealing the spotlight. So I stayed back and did my job, and I like a smoke while I'm playing, you know. It's a long time getting on stage and off stage, and I'm a little more comfortable. So I sit up there and watch it all go by. I got the best seat in the house. I get to see the pretty girls up front. I don't get blasted out by these guys' amps, you know. They're 10 feet high stack of amps. It all goes right by me, so I just get to sit there and watch it roll on by. It's real good.
What about the hamburgers?
Well, I'm a cheeseburger fan just because it's the safest food in the world. You can find a cheeseburger anywhere. You know. Can't find chocolate ice cream in New Zealand sometimes, but you can always find a cheeseburger. You know. Woo!
Get that.
Okay. Right. Robin, how do you feel about being these sort of put up as the handsome one of the band, you know, sort of the smooth superstar?
Well, I don't know. Let's see. I guess you really can't think about it that much. I mean, you sit around, think about it, take it that seriously, because it's really not. I'm just interested in doing the best job I can, and I'm a musician, and that's basically what I think about. The other stuff is just all icing on the cake, I guess. It's better to have girls following you around than not have girls following you around, right?
And here are two members of the Dream Police, Cheap Trick. We've got Rick Nielsen right beside me in the red, the very bright red.
Oh, good morning, Tracy. I think we should have seen some more of that film, that video. I mean, we're so handsome and we play so well. I mean, gee, I think we should have been on there a little more, Tracy, but it's your show, so let's do whatever you want.
Okay, and then I'll introduce you to Tom, who's a quiet type and doesn't say much. But well, I'm sure we'll fix that up by the end of the interview, won't we, Tom? For sure.
We could.
Ladies and gentlemen, Tracy is rubbing it in our noses that she's going to L.A. today. And we just came from there, and I hope that L.A. will be the same after you leave there.
Oh, I should hope so, too.
Because, maybe it'd be nice if it would change a bit. I don't know if you've ever been to L.A. There's a few changes that should happen there. But as long as we're in New Zealand and we're here with you, Tracy, what do you want to know?
Right, okay. Now, your latest album, which is called Dream Police, look, leave it up to me.
Oh.
I'm the interviewer.
You're the interviewer. Yeah, that's right. We're the interviewees.
Okay. Now, your latest album is Dream Police, which we just saw a little bit of. Where did the who was the inspiration for Dream Police?
Kiwi Carlos, our drummer. No, actually, I wrote that tune. The tune is called Dream Police, and that's the name of our new album, as you said.
Yes.
Man, you've got all the facts.
Ica,
you're very good.
Ica.
And, we worked at that, and it was an old tune we had about 10 years ago, and we worked and worked and worked, could never get the right arrangement, the right feel. But finally, about 9 months ago, or 10 months ago, when we recorded the record, came up with all the goods, and now it just came out, and we just heard some good, great news. It's number 3 in the charts next week here in New Zealand, and I love it, because we've got such good music. It's neat that... that you and I and he like it. Huh?
Very much indeed. Now, my favorite off the album is called Voices.
You're a romantic.
I'm a romantic.
Girl.
All right,
oh,
okay.
Oh, my God, Tracy.
Right.
I've heard stories about you.
I'm a romantic.
Backstage
I like
at the town hall, I heard about that.
Who composed it?
I wrote it.
You're guilty.
I confess.
Right, okay then. When you're sitting down, do you sit down and all together work out the music and the words together, or is it just you work something out in your head first, or how does it work?
Well, actually, I start out, I try to do most of the things in Russian, and then I go to one of the dictionaries, and I translate it to Spanish, and usually, because I have such schizophrenic ideas, they usually end up to be almost coherent in English. So that's how that one happened, and but that was just how the song Voices went. And if you listen to the beginning of the song Voices, it has sounds like a muscle like that, and it's actually it's all the song titles of from all our
who
records.
Who sort that bit out?
All.
I think it was Tom's idea. You know, he's a brilliant, whisper man.
Good one. Please hear that. Now, on last week, which was on Friday, on Good Times Sounds, we had a Cheap Trick special, and everyone loved it, especially the stage antics that you guys get up to.
Yeah.
Where do you get the energy from?
Well, I don't take drugs. How about that?
I'm pleased to hear that.
Yeah.
Okay. What about you, Tom? Where do you get all your energy from for on stage? Is it just something that builds up with the adrenaline of going
on
stage?
Yes, it builds up usually right before the show.
Yeah. And you're always
like this?
He
gets a little encouragement right before the show.
Yeah, really, it's like just the adrenaline.
Well, okay, you've got two sort of completely distinct personalities in the group. You've got Rick, who's sort of very bouncy and bright and
bright.
Weird.
Let's keep it bright. I like that.
And then we've got Tom, who's into the quiet, but still into a rage. Now, how did you two get into these sort of characteristics, okay? Think this one out. Now, think it
well,
carefully.
Well, let's see. Well, Ashley...
How did I become quiet, and how did he become zany?
No, well,
I have a bigger mouth. I speak more. I interrupt him at all times.
No.
Yes,
my
I do.
Mouth
I do.
My mouth is bigger.
His mouth is bigger, and he has a lower voice, but see... That's the reason I'm sitting closer to you, because see, you have this high soprano voice, and then I go to the tenor voice, and then Tom comes over to the baritone voice, and it's sort of like when you call your dog or you whistle for your pigs. If you have this certain range of sound that picks up by certain animals to their ear, to their ears, and so that's why I speak the most. Yeah, have you ever you've heard of those dog whistles, haven't you? You hear that? Now, if you hear the dogs running towards you right now, that's because the dogs like you.
All right. Now, we saw in the Auckland Star that you had an absolutely brilliant write-up in the Auckland Star. Everyone that I've spoken to loved the concert.
Except Jimmy Carter didn't like it.
He didn't like it?
He said we were a little too loud, and he said the audience got up and enjoyed themselves. I think that that's a crime or something.
Well,
how
did you
feel? I think they want to make sure that the show is safe. I don't want the building to fall down on me either. So
it won't.
It won't.
Well, I've got this protective helmet on here, so no problem.
Okay, now how did you think the Auckland concert went? Did you like the reaction from the small crowd that was the, well, not wasn't small, but it's small in comparison to the Japan. Pardon, what are you going on about?
Sign language. I said, yes, it's great. I liked
good,
it.
Good.
Okay.
Pleased to hear.
Yeah. As a matter of fact, I did eat lunch at Raffles today, so I'm enjoying myself in town.
What's that like?
And it was good food. Yeah, I think I had they had this meringue dessert. It was wonderful. And
okay, righto. Now you're in Auckland tonight for another concert, and then tomorrow night, and then you're down south.
Yeah, we go to Wellington, and let's see, we're here tonight, town hall. Tomorrow night, town hall. Friday night, Wellington, then a day off to do some press down in Christchurch for 2 days,
mm-hmm.
and we play two shows there, and then we go to Australia.
Australia, and you've
ever heard
actually,
of that? That's yeah, a little city over up north.
It's the end of New Zealand.
North
yeah.
West,
mm-hmm.
It's near Tasmania,
mm-hmm.
I think.
Yeah.
Okay, then. So you're going to have a brilliant time, and then you're racing off to leave. What about Melbourne later on in the year? Anything coming?
We're working on a record right now. Yeah, yes, we are.
Live? Is it all going to be in studio?
Well, it's going to be live at your house. We're bringing the machines over this afternoon. As long as you're going to California today, we can just go over and set up the stuff. And if you want to come over and be on the live at Tracy's album, I think it'd be great. You know, it could make you famous.
Yeah, we could.
Sounds like a good idea.
We could really push it.
Nice to be here in New Zealand. Really, I think so. Bunny and Robin say they wish they were here, especially to see you in this dress today, Tracy.
Oh, look, aren't the flattery. We'll get them everywhere as far as I'm concerned.
They can see it on TV.
Well, thank you very much for coming on the Good Time Show this afternoon, and have a brilliant time in NZ, won't you?
Thank you, CBS. Thank you, Tracy. Thank you, Good Times.
And don't forget to watch out for the Dream Police. They're coming to your town very, very shortly. But right now, let's go now and see. Da-da-da-da.
Da-da-da-da-da.
You don't know what it's called, do you?
I have no idea.
Let's see.
It's Jimmy Carter going wild.
It's
I think
not.
He's going to hate you.